And welcome back to Let's Play Undertale, Blind. This episode, unfortunately, at least part of it, will not be blind. Unfortunately, the last two times I tried to record this got botched up. I got 2 seconds of recording and then it stopped for some weird reason. I have to remember to keep checking the little indicator that it's recording. At the end of the episode, I saw that it was not, and I was not pleased. And then I tried to record again. And my computer, well, for whatever reason, the power cord was not all the way in, and I pushed it because it was kind of like sitting diagonal on a desk, and it shut off because the power cord went out a little bit too far, and yeah, power down. So anyway, before I say anything here, sans. I'm thinking about getting into the telescope business. It's normally 50,000 gold to use this premium telescope. But, since I know you, you can use it for free. How's about it? We'll use it. Kind of reminds you a lot of... How's it go? It's James Bond. But, now we have that on our eye. Huh? You aren't satisfied? Don't worry. I'll give you a full refund, yes, of $0. That's an odd-looking telescope. Here's our normal box. Notice I put my bandana in there, and I have nice creams in there. This guy's here again. And the ancient glyphs have been painted over with a list of 21 different flavors. It's the frozen treat that warms your heart. Now, when I first play this, well, then tell your friends, there's ice cream, hidden in the depths of a watery cavern. I bought a bunch of nice creams from him. He has this new system where if you buy the nice creams, I don't remember if they're 25 gold before or not, but if you buy 3 of them, you get a punch card, which is stored in here until you retrieve them. It's a box for storing punch cards. It's empty right now. So I have one of these punch cards, and a couple nice creams, and a few more in a box outside. Battle item. Used to make punching attacks stronger in one battle. Use outside of battle to look at the card. Now he said he came here because he wanted more business, but doesn't seem to be improving over here. So he wanted to add the punch cards as an added incentive type thing. Please, please come back. So, I kept one to use during battle, just in case. I'm not always battling everything anyway. So, notice that we've taken our bandana off, and now I'm wearing the ribbon again. Yeah, last episode... Yeah, I hate that you missed it, guys. I don't know of a way to go back, because it only saves one, you know. Unless I go after every playthrough and make a copy of the save kind of thing. There's no way to like rewind or load a save kind of thing, so... I'm sure there's a way to do it. But, of which I do not know. Maybe you have to do it ahead of time like I was saying, make a copy of it, and then you have, you know, a couple saves. But anyway, Papyrus was telling us that, right. We told him, I believe, last episode. He asked what we were wearing. I think that was last episode. Hopefully it wasn't the episode that was lost. He asked what we were wearing, and he said, yes, are you wearing a bandana? And he got a choice of yes or no. So I told him no, because I didn't really trust him. Undyne is putting pressure on him to, you know, capture us, find us, that kind of thing. So I told him no, that we were wearing a bandana. I lied, even though I was. And then he said, well, since I'm going to tell you who, you know, he calls again. And he said, well, I'm going to tell you who, you know, was somebody really scary. I'm not sure if he specifically said it was Undyne or not. But he said, since you told me you were wearing a bandana, you told me you were not wearing a bandana, that he told Undyne that I'm wearing a bandana. So I've switched to bandana. And I put on the ribbon thing. At least for now. So, yeah, I wonder what happened if we would have told him, yeah, we're wearing a bandana. I wonder what I would have done then. So this little onion thing. What's a star? Can you touch it? Can you eat it? Can you kill it? Are you a star? Please don't touch or eat me. This way is a dead end. There's a duck. I don't know how to get to that. But you can go this way. Now, I don't know how to get to these other areas that you can see. See, I can't get there, that island, to the, upper right. Here's a place that we could possibly hide from Undyne. Haven't had to, though. Really can't go anywhere. Someone's gonna fight us in a second. You hear a passing conversation. Just one, but it's kind of stupid. That's actually started here. So, don't you have any wishes to make? So we came from there, right? Washua. I don't know if you saw us fight this thing. Attack 18, defense 5. This humble germaphobe seeks to cleanse the whole world. Washu leg. I really don't like the attacks for this freaking thing. I'm surprised I did that. Washu wonders if tears are sanitary. Touch? You reach out. Washu recoils from your touch. Yuck! Doing rather well. Clean? You ask Washua to clean you. It hops around excitedly. Green means clean. Oh, does it mean I want the... I was trying to get that green thing. Washua is rinsing off a pizza. I want to get one of those green ones. I haven't, done that yet. I didn't get it. And I'm hurting myself trying to. One more try. Well, does that mean I gain points back? I wasn't looking. Guess so. Oh, we can, let's just try this, though. Joke. You tell a joke about a kid who slept in the soil. Well, she was powers neutralized. No, that joke's too dirty. Not too great, but... Now we can't go past this thing. I'm thinking maybe we come back here at a later time and we're like on the lower portion or something, I don't know. Don't say that. Come on. I promise I won't laugh. The power to take their souls. This is the power that the humans feared. Yeah, this guy's a pain. I can't move. Dun 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 dun! It's Cthulhu! Hey, there! Noticed you were here? I'm Undyne-san. Undyne-san, you here? Yeah, great. You're visiting Waterfall, huh? It's great here, huh? You love it, huh? Yeah, me too. It's my big favorite. Something like that. Even though the water's getting so shallow here, I have to sit down all the time, but... Hey, that's okay. It beats moving to the city and living in a crowded aquarium, like all my friends did. What kind of onion things live in an aquarium? And the aquarium's full anyway, so even if I wanted to, I... That's okay, though. You hear? Undyne's gonna fix everything, you hear? I'm gonna get out of here and live in the ocean. You hear? Yes, goodbye-bye's. Hey, there. That's the end of this room. I'll see you around. Have a good time. In Waterfall! Eh. Shyman hides in the corner, but somehow encounters you anyway. Attack 19, defense 0. Tone deaf, she's too ashamed to sing her deadly song. Hum hum. Shyman thinks about doing karaoke by herself. You hum a funky tune. Shyman follows your melody. Shyman seems much more comfortable singing along. We can actually spare her now, but... Let's smile. You smile. You asked to see Shyman smile, too. She's already smiling. Shyman gets quieter. In the corner, Aaron nods his head approvingly. Aaron likes Shyman to be quieter. Oh, damn, I got hit. Shyman seems much more comfortable singing along. You wave your arms wildly. You are now vulnerable to electric attacks. Are these electric attacks? The northern room hides a great treasure. A haunting song echoes down the corridor. Won't you play along? Only the first 8 are fine. How much... We're really not good with hit points right now, but let me just see. Okay, we don't hear the song yet, because it's something I have to do. This power has no counter. Indeed, a human cannot take a monster's soul. When a monster dies, its soul disappears. And an incredible power would be needed to take the soul of a living monster. There was only one exception. The soul of a special species of monster called a boss monster. A boss monster's soul is strong enough to persist after death, if only for a few moments. A human could absorb this soul, but this has never happened. And now it never will. Why not? It's a statue. The structures at its feet seem dry. Please take one. These are umbrellas. You took an umbrella. Excuse me. Put the umbrella on the statue. See? You place the umbrella atop the statue. Inside the statue, a music box begins to play. The music continues and doesn't stop. Alright, so I've written this down, and it's the same as last time. For some reason it didn't work the first couple times I did it, so I'm not sure. And I do have it written down correctly, so we'll see. Play it? C. Oh, wait, I'm doing this wrong here. Heh There's Greater Dog talking there for a second. Now let me just see something. I don't have it yet. See what happens. It's a legendary artifact. Will you take it? You're carrying too many dogs. Now this is what made me want to play this part over anyway. I have an annoying dog. Annoying dog. Dog. A little white dog. It's fast asleep. When I let it loose in the room with the artifact, it absorbed the artifact and ran off. It's not there. The dog's gone. Dog's back. It's only in my inventory in that room. What do I do? Can't do anything with the dog because it's always in my inventory, obviously, in that room. So I can't, like, leave and put in a box somewhere or let it go somewhere else. Now what I did was I used the dog and it went on the artifact. What if I drop the dog? You put the dog on the ground. This is what happened. The dog absorbs the artifact. The artifact is gone. What does the sign say? Maybe we'll catch up to the dog later? I don't know what else to do with it, guys. Unless I could have something else in my... Yeah, not anymore. Unless I could have something else in my inventory to do with the dog? I don't know. Another one just in case. Okay. Now back to blind territory, guys. I have not been in this room. That looks like we could fall down. Was that just water? Okay, never mind. Oh, it's this crazy thing. Yo, you got an umbrella? Awesome. Let's go. Where are we going? I guess you're going wherever I'm going. I wouldn't be surprised if one of these is a pit or something. Man, Undyne is so cool. She beats up bad guys and never loses. If I was a human, I would wet the bed every night. Knowing when she was going to beat me up. Yeah, well, I'm not a bad guy. So, one time, we had a school project where we had to take care of a flower. the king, we had to call him Mr. Dreamer, volunteered to donate his own flowers. He ended up coming to school and teaching the class about responsibility and stuff. That got me thinking, yo, how cool would it be if Undyne came to school? She could beat up all the teachers. Whatever the hell you are, shut up. maybe she wouldn't beat up the teachers. She's too cool to ever hurt an innocent person. Oh no? Oh wow. What do we have here? A cutscene? Or is this... Oh, okay. I thought something was gonna happen. Later? Okay, you're back? More umbrellas. You can get your own umbrella. Yo, this ledge is way too steep. Yo, you want to see Undyne, right? Climb on my shoulders. Alright, let me get the umbrella back. I don't know. Yo, you aren't going to be able to climb with an umbrella. Okie doke. Later. Yo, you go on ahead. Don't worry about me. I always find a way to get through. And fall on your face while doing so. Good, save point. The serene sound of a distant music box. It fills you with determination. And whenever we're filled with determination, we can save. The humans, afraid of our power, declared war on us. They attacked suddenly and without mercy. In the end, it could hardly be called a war. United, the humans were too powerful, and us monsters too weak. Not a single soul was taken, and countless monsters were turned to dust. How sad. Still, we don't want you taking our souls. Undyne? What is this? What the fraggin? Ooh! Oh crap. Oh! Ugh. Oof. Bitch. Oh, I'm a dead end. Ugh. Oh, where the hell am I supposed to go? Are you kidding? Don't lose hope. Okay. At least we get to save right before. Thank you. don't know where I'm supposed to be going. Ah! Away from me! I am not interested. Damn it! I couldn't move. There we go. I'm almost dead. Damn it. Now what? That's a dead end. But the attack stopped. Great. I don't have a lot of points left at this time. No! Ah! It sounds like it came from over here. Oh. You've fallen down, haven't you? I have no idea who's talking. Are you okay? Here. Get up. Garnet, huh? I love I'm guessing I'm back by the statue. With the music box inside. I love the little melody, too. It's nice. That's a nice name. My name is... Oh, a bed of flowers. Oh. It's like all water. Should I be sticking to... Oh, this is a lot of garbage here. Piles of garbage. There are quite a few brands you recognize. Brands of garbage? Just garbage. Garbage. A trash heap. Your persistent garbage habit shows no signs of payoff. Trash. Piles of garbage. Okay. The waterfall here seems to flow from the ceiling of the cavern. Occasionally, a piece of trash will flow through and fall into the bottomless abyss below. Viewing this endless cycle of worthless garbage, it fills you with determination. Piles of garbage, yeah, same. Just garbage. Alright, thanks for watching, guys. See you in the next episode. And hopefully that will record just fine. It will be completely blind. See you next time, and endure. In enduring, go strong.